Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Last time around, we had Death of the Undying, where basically Barry went after his body, which led Roy and the gang to the third laboratory. They split up. Al and Riza went off one direction, while Roy and Havoc went another direction, and they ended up running into Lust, who started to beat them because she knew Roy's weakness with water. And she stabbed through Jean and even stabbed through Roy, and they were starting to bleed to death. And she went over to face Al and Riza, and they weren't really doing that well. But then, luckily, Roy came in with a lighter and a transmutation circle carved into his hand, and he just lit her the fuck up. Like, wow. It was like a savage ass whooping, really. Like, it's one of the greatest things I've ever seen in anime, is just him annihilating her. And sure enough, Roy Mustang has defeated and killed Lust. So, yeah, that was pretty crazy. And then at the end, we cut back to Ed, who found his father. Yeah, his dad's just there in Rizimbul. So, that's crazy, right? Yeah, that's crazy. So, oh boy. So yeah, really, really interesting stuff. Great stuff last episode, and it makes me excited to get into this episode. So yeah, like always, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure. So let's go ahead and jump right into this episode of Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood. Here we go. Well, what an interesting episode. Very, very interesting episode. That was very, very interesting. Like, it's weird, like, it's closure on some of it, and also inspiring of, yes, we know how to do this now. So, very, very interesting, you know? Alrighty. We are going to start. We've got one name to look up this time. Hohenheim, played by John Swayze. And I'm going to be very, very careful about what I'm looking at, because it is as yet unconfirmed if Hohenheim is father. So I will stay away from that as much as I can. Wish me luck. Alright. Here. If I do this, then I can only see the titles. Brilliant! Oh, looks like he plays Dodoria. And the ZTV announcer in Dragon Ball Z Kai? Alright. Oh, wait a second. Attack on Titan. Zachary, Premier Zachary. Wait, that means then, oh my god, he's All for One. Oh no. Oh, that's dangerous. Oh, that is very dangerous. Okay. There. I made it through. I don't know if there would be spoilers on that, but if there were, I sure as hell didn't see him. All right. Yay. Man, their dad is played by All for One. Oh, no. Man, that just makes me think he is actually father. You know? Oh, my gosh. All righty. So. Yeah. Very, very interesting episodes. Very, very interesting episode. Okay, so we got the reunion between Ed and Hohenheim. Interesting, though, on the credits here, he's listed as Van Hohenheim. But I would presume it's Hohenheim Elric. Because that's their name is Elric. So, I don't know. I guess it could be Van Hohenheim Elric. Or maybe it's Elric Van Hohenheim. That'd be weird. That doesn't make sense. Anyway. So, yes. We got the meeting. We got the meeting between them. And... yeah, that was awkward. So, last episode, I was saying that the look on his face was different to how we've seen him in the two intros we've had, where, you know, he had a more stern look, where here he had a more sort of sorrowful look. And then he proceeded to... I guess maybe it was sort of a tough love with Ed of, you know, you didn't burn the house down so that you wouldn't turn back. You did it so you would bury your mistakes. You would, you know, you could run away from it. And it's like, I guess. It's like, I guess you could say that. But at the same time, no, I don't know. I mean, it's not something, obviously it's not something Ed and Al consciously did, but I guess you could sort of view it that way. But now, Ed has gone back and dug up the body, so I guess it's sort of a tough love thing from old Hohenheim, so yeah. And they reinforce the whole stuff with souls not being compatible with other bodies, which is interesting. And yeah, sometimes a body will be fine for a while. Like, you know, Al's been in that body, for years at this point? For like 4 years at this point, and the body keeps going, you know? I guess when Al was was bonded to that demon body, that didn't last. Now something that's interesting, I can't remember what the body said just before basically it died. Now we know that it wasn't Trisha. B, it wasn't some random soul put in there to suffer and die. It was Al. It was Al, specifically. But I can't, for the life of me, remember what it said. It may have just said Edward, you know? It's Al calling out to his brother. But the thing is that, especially on this show, when Al calls to him, he says, brother. And that's why it's like in the back of my mind, like, well, wait a minute. What was, I don't know. But I'll go with it. I mean, Al remembered seeing through that body. So, yeah. Hohenheim departed. Hohenheim departed, saying that something terrible is about to happen in this country, which is crazy. And, yeah, after everything of, you know, did they actually, you know, bring back Trisha? You know, what was the color of its hair? What was the color of its eyes? And see, okay, now I will say that I was wrong, apparently. So what it must have been was they do the human transmutation. Al is obliterated, Ed loses his leg, and then he loses his arm by bonding Al's soul to the armor. The creature that we now know is Al dies there. They get out of there Al gets Ed out of there now in the suit of armor, and Pinako does go down there to see basically the corpse that remains, and later the house is burned down by the Elrics. But what I always thought from the second episode was that, you know, this creature is down there and Roy Mustang shows up and burns that creature to death. I was wrong. I was wrong. Roy only showed up after they burned, well, after all of that, because he did see the corpse that was left there. But that's what it was a corpse. We now know that Al died there, basically. So it's very interesting. You know, it's a very interesting proposition, or not proposition, but it's a very interesting thing of, like, human transmutation. We have just proved that human transmutation is impossible, you know? Because you just simply cannot bring back the dead. There's nothing either, you know, Ed, Al, or Izumi forgot. They just, it is physically impossible. And yeah, so the baby that was created was not their baby. The body that was created was not their mother. It was Al. Well, I mean, it's not that it was Al, because it was still black hair, but it was a new body created and Al was put inside, you know? But it's completely impossible to bring back the dead. Except, you can bond a soul to a suit of armor. And I find that very, very interesting. I've always sort of found that interesting of everything, you know? That of all the things, you know, because alchemy is so, you know, scientifically based and everything, you know, we have an entire episode about, you know, religion versus science and stuff like that, you know, blind faith and devotion versus, you know, facts and math and logic and stuff like that. Yet in all of this, souls exist. What seems to be the most unscientific thing, a soul exists. And you can, you know, a person can basically, if it's distilled down to its essence, a person is that soul. And that, through alchemy, can be bonded to a suit of armor. And I find that very, very interesting. It makes me wonder, could they bond their mother's soul to a suit of armor? Now, you do have to wonder, how quick is that? How quick is this process? How quick does it need to be? Do you need to bond the soul immediately, or can you just do it at any point? Could they, right now, despite the fact that it's been years since their mother's death, could they right now bond her soul to a suit of armor? I'm going to imagine no. No, that's not a thing. So I still find that fascinating, where we've put the kibosh on it for now, at the very least, that human transmutation is impossible. It seems odd. So yeah, it seems very strange to me, you know? But they dug up the body. It was not their mother. It was a new body, basically. And that became Al, which is interesting. So, yeah, that was interesting. And that's also the confirmation with Izumi that she did not recreate her baby. It was something else completely. It was impossible for that child to come from either of them. So, yeah. And I find it very interesting. I mean, I really like that this is basically closure. For a bit of closure, at least. you know, where Izumi has been looking at this forever, basically, thinking, I must have done something wrong, you know? There must be something I missed. And even, you know, we get a bit of that with Roy, you know, after Hughes dies, and he says to Risa, you know, I'm running through every calculation in my head on how to successfully perform human transmutation. But the fact is, it's completely impossible. And I do like that does actually give them a little closure, especially for Izumi, where she's like, look, my baby died, but I didn't bring it back to suffer, you know? And I did like that, that moment of, you know, our baby did not suffer and die twice, you know, because of me, because of my mistakes, basically. Now, we don't know what the hell soul went into that body that she created, but it wasn't her baby. And I like that that's weird, a very interesting sort of closure, you know? So, yeah. And then that basically confirms that while, yes, you cannot bring something back from the dead, it does confirm that they can get Al's body back, you know? Because this is Al. This is his soul. And his body is somewhere out there. Just like Barry's was separate from his soul, Al's body is out there. Currently under the possession of the truth. And I don't know how they're going to do it, but come hell and high water, they are going to go kick the truth's ass. I don't know how you do that. Maybe there's some notes they can find, you know, some old theories. How? Because the only way someone's ever been able to see the truth is through human transmutation, you know? And as far as we know, only 3 people have ever done that. Izumi, who did it first, and then Ed and Al. Those are the only people we know can do this, you know? And the interesting thing is, how this has to, on some level, tie into Father and the 7 homunculi. It has to tie into that, you know? This can't be a separate thing, you know? Well, I say 7 homunculi. It is 6 now, so... Though, one of those homunculi, could be the dad. I mean, Pinako said, like, all this time and you haven't aged a day. Like, it's like, I don't know. Unless he's got the Tom Cruise effect, or unless Tom Cruise is a homunculus, who knows? Scientology, they're weird, I don't know. I say that with literally no knowledge of anything Scientology. I just know they're fucking weird. That's about it. Anyway, don't explain Scientology in the comments, by the way. I don't care. So yeah. Interesting stuff. We're going to try to find the truth and kick his ass and take Al's body back, which is crazy. And I like, you know, I did like that moment when they're talking about that, reaffirming all of this and, you know, with the determination to go find the truth. I like that not only are... Not only is Winry listening to all of that, I like that Ling Yao and Lanfan were listening to that too. I thought that was really interesting. Because, yeah, you know, he's looking for the secrets of immortality and stuff, and so he's going over, it's like, well, what about this? What about this? What about this? And stuff. And now he's listening to them, and he may be getting some ideas like, well, wait, there's something about this truth they're talking about. We definitely need to stick with them, you know? So, I'm very interested with how Ling Yao will tie into all of this as well, you know? He's such an interesting character, and I like how he's basically just inserted himself into the story, but he's great. I love him. So, yeah. The last thing to sort of talk about is the promise. A promise that, unfortunately, Trisha was not able to keep, apparently. But what is the promise? I don't know, but if we ever see Hohenheim again, I guess we'll find out. So, yeah. Crazy episode this was. Very, very crazy. I turned into Yoda for a second. Crazy episode this was. But really, really good. And oddly had some closure and was a bit inspiring. Like, yeah, let's go do this, you know? So, very, very interesting stuff. And I can't wait to see where we are going from here. But that is basically it. With all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. There's a bunch of links on screen if you want to go click around to any of those. There's a playlist for all of my Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood reactions, as well as another video you can go click on if you want. There's also a subscribe button and a Patreon button on screen, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys later.